So as far as the Olympic silver medalists were concerned in that men's doubles, Gobi Shem and Tan Wee Kyong, I know they will be disappointed with their own performance, but take nothing away from Li Junhui and Liu Yuchen, because they went all out attack today and that paid dividends for them. Next up is men's singles and Viktor Axelsen, who's been beaten in the final here in Delhi for the last 2 years. He's making his fourth consecutive appearance here. He's up against a man who's only making his second appearance, but Wang Tzu Wei has been having a tremendous start to the year. He's been in great form. After that, we will have mixed doubles and Chris and Gabby Adcock, the Commonwealth Games gold medalists, up against Isara, who's a former champion here. He won the men's doubles back in 2012 with Manapong Jongjit. Now he's playing mixed doubles with Amak Thrapai. And then we finish with that winning single, Saina Nehwal, against Pusala Venkata Sindhu. It's not only that, the whole of India is waiting to see. Most of the world is waiting to see that women's singles, the two outstanding female athletes from the sport here in India. Well, as far as the men's singles draw is concerned from quarterfinal stage, we only had three seeds left. We did lose the number one and two seeds before the start of competition, though. Li Chong Wei, three-time former champion, withdrew, as did Janne Jorgensen. But when you look at the lineup there, Tommy Sugiarto, he's been a world championship medalist. Viktor Axelsen, he's the bronze medalist from the Olympic Games last year. And of course, players scattered all over the place who have been in Super Series tournament finals. So it's still an exceptionally strong draw. But as far as Axelsen is concerned, he's the highest seed in the tournament because, as I was just saying, the number one and two seeds withdrew. So as the number three seed, Viktor Axelsen, I suppose on paper, is expected to win this title. Reached the final 2 years ago when he lost out to Shrikant Kadambi in three games. And then last year, lost the final to Kento Momota of Japan. And we hear exciting news that Momota may be about to return to competition. I'm not sure whether that's international competition.
So here.
But suspended by his own federation. Well, Axelsen making it quite clear. That he wishes to start this near side of the court. So the players will take their racket bags to the appropriate end of the court before the start of play. Wang Tzu Wei only turned 22 last month and he's enjoying his third week at a career high of 20. Born in Taipei. Silver medalist from the World Junior Championships in Bangkok in 2013. This is the first ever Super Series quarterfinal for this young man from Taipei. Well, it's his fifth tournament of the year, fifth individual tournament of the year. In the first round, he beat Wong Wing Kee of Hong Kong. And then last year's beaten finalist from the All England Championships, the left-hander and number five seed Tian Hao Wei. So both of those matches in two straight games, which is an indication of just what terrific form he's been in. He reached the final of the German Grand Prix gold and semi-final of the Swiss Grand Prix gold. For Viktor Axelsen, well, he's only played one tournament prior to this year. The 23-year-old from Odense, which is where we play the Denmark Open, has been as high as 11 weeks as number three in the world from the 22nd of December, the end of last year. So two-time beaten finalist here, and he's played two top-rated Indian players in the first two rounds, AJ Jayaram, and then beat the man who had beaten him in the final 2 years ago, Shrikant Kadambi. And look at the scoreline, 21-7, 21-12, just 25 minutes to dispose of the former champion, Kadambi. So Viktor Axelsen in sharp form. This will be the first meeting between these two players. And therefore they won't know each other's style terribly well, so I'm sure that Wang Tzu Wei will have studied videos of his opponent, Viktor Axelsen, as we look at our court officials for this one. Axelsen just won tournament, as I was saying, prior to this.
Ready to play.
The All England, where he lost in the quarterfinal to the then defending champion, Lin Dan. Lost in three games. I know at the Danish National Championships, he twisted his ankle in the quarterfinal stage, but I watched carefully during the All England Championships and there didn't appear to be any sign of struggling with that injury. Well, this man on his way through to the final in Germany in Mülheim beat the world and Olympic champion Chen Long in the semi-final stage in three games. So that's an indication as we look at Kenneth Jonasson.
Thank you.
Danish coach and singles coach. He's head coach now to the Danish
national team.
Ladies
and gentlemen, on my right, Viktor Axelsen, Denmark. And on my left, Tzu Wei Wang, Chinese Taipei. Tzu Wei Wang to serve. Love all. Play.
Wang Tzu Wei. Oh, Chinese Taipei. Oh, this quarterfinal underway. Well, already Axelsen, a little surprised.
One. Love.
I think that was, yeah, that one. Was that a double hit?
Service over. One.
Well, it'll be interesting to see this young man from Taipei.
Service over.
Just 22 years of age, whether he's a little nervous
two,
at the start of his
one.
First ever Super Series quarterfinal. Yeah. Well, it didn't look like a double hit.
Three, one.
Well, the final in Germany,
two,
when he
three.
Played against Chao Tien Chen, was the first time in history that the men's singles final at a Grand Prix gold event had been two players from Taipei contesting the final. A history maker. Talented, as indeed is Viktor Axelsen. We know about the talent of Viktor Axelsen because he's already been in seven Super Series tournament finals. And in Dubai at the end of last year, at the Super Series finals, won his first ever Super Series title. Obviously in his seventh final. Must have been beginning to wonder whether it would ever happen. Mind you, it only happened in an eighth final for the former world and Olympic champion, Taufik Hidayat. In fact, he was, ooh, the challenge here. He was in 10 Super Series tournament finals, only won one of them. And Kenichi Targo was in seven and didn't win any of them. So the challenge here. What does Hawkeye say? Hawkeye says it was out.
Challenge unsuccessful. Viktor Axelsen, one challenge remaining. Five, three, play.
Three long in the racket of Wang Tzu Wei. He's a quick player. Very, very quick. Coming forward too. I know that wasn't one of those occasions, but just watch his net play later on. I was very impressed with it during the European tour of tournaments, the German, All England and the Swiss.
Yeah. 6-3. Play. Service over. 4-6.
Yeah, he uses his height so well, does Axelsen. He's 194, that's 6'4".
Service over. 5-7. Service over. 8-5.
That's a good backhand play.
Service over. 6-9.
His Olympic bronze medal. Viktor Axelsen, I ought to mention his World Championship bronze medal as well. One at home in Copenhagen in 2014.
7-9.
Lost that semi-final to Lee Chong Wei. That was never out. Never out.
Victor Alenges, challenges.
It's called out, card, and that out. Has to be a challenge. And I'll eat my hat if it's called out by Hawkeye. Yeah. There we go.
Correction in.
Two fans on their feet. It was that forehand defence that turned the whole momentum of the rally, managing to block across court. So on a run of five straight points from a four-point deficit,
nine.
Now a one-point advantage. No, has landed in.
11-9 interval.
Run there for Viktor Axelsen. And a two-point advantage at the mid-game interval. Something about the net play and the coaching staff there to Wang Tzu Wei. Three finals.
Good one. 20 seconds.
Wei last year. One
good
of them
one.
Not a
20 seconds.
Ranking tournament. That was the World University Championships in Oranskoye in Russia. They won the Dutch Grand Prix, beating AJ Jairam in the final. And he reached the final of the Vietnam International Challenger event as well in Hanoi. He's not even won a Grand Prix gold event.
11-9.
I do like that career path and career development coming up through the International Challengers, then the Grand Prix, then doing well in Grand Prix gold events, and now here he is.
10,
first
11.
Ever Super Series quarter final. Look at that net play. Oh, it's called a fault. It's called a fault. I suspect the umpire was right there.
12, 10.
Can't tell from that. Just right. And finally, the run comes to an end.
Service over.
Is that 11, seven straight points
12.
For this man? Yeah, just wide.
Service over.
Must have been close.
13-11.
Oh, look at that.
Service over. 12-13.
Watch his movement here. By the time he's hitting the shuttle, body weight is coming forward. Look at this. Leaps in the air, it's landing, and his body weight's moving forward back towards the net again. Incredible power in the legs. Good judgment.
Service over. 13-14.
Oh, good neck control. Yeah, pounced on that.
Service over. 15, 30.
Look at that control there. That was the one that did the damage. Start of this match, 16. I said watch out for Wang Tzu Wei coming forward to the net and how quickly he's coming forward. I think Axelsen has counteracted that with his own speed forward. He's looking very sharp, tall down. Slip on the left leg of Axelsen, just slipped away 14, from him as he played that first 17. Defensive shot. There we are. Yeah, I was right. Maybe just it's disturbed his concentration a little. This 17. Opening game. Just 1 point in it now. Oh, clever. Clever, clever play 17. From Wang Tzu Wei. He hasn't used the body smash much. It was perfect timing. And it's all level. 17 all. Oh, this is extraordinary. Fluctuation in fortunes. 17. I think it was right to go for it, in my opinion. Yep, went for it again. This time it works. Yeah, that takes courage.
18.
Been a run of five straight points from Wang Tzu Wei. Yeah, well taken. I think he actually played that shot backhand. No wonder it went wide. Oh, well taken. Helped by the net cord. Wang Tzu Wei. He apologises for his good fortune. Two game point opportunities for Wang Tzu Wei. That's the one where it got deflected. That defensive shot. Oh, what a net shot. That's a good lift too. Oh! What a good rally. Oh my goodness, now he's hurt himself.
20.
Landed heavily on his hip. Did Wang Tzu Wei. Ah, it was clever from Axelsen. on his right hip. Yeah, look at that. That hurt. Saved by Axelsen.
Like, let.
On serve, gifts the opening game to Wang Tzu Wei. 21-19 confirms the umpire. 19 minutes for game number one. Yeah, the flick serve, it was a nice idea, trying something a little different, but went long of that back line. Three seed Viktor Axelsen is going to have to come back from behind if he's going to have any chance of making it through finals in 3 years here in Delhi. Axelsen returns to court long before the 22nd remaining call is made.
Yeah. Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
And there is the 22nd call. And that's the clear indication to return. Ah, now lots of notes being written down there from Kenneth Jonasson. Yeah, he probably hasn't seen a lot of Wang Tzu Wei either. No doubt he's a talented player. You don't go beating Chen Long in semi-finals of Grand Prix
Second
Gold
game.
Events unless you're pretty handy.
Like.
Inside the back line.
Two.
Now, it was a very positive call when he won the toss from Viktor Axelsen. But he wanted to start this near side of the court.
Three. Love.
Where's Steen Petersen when you need him? He, of course, knows Viktor Axelsen much better than I do, and I wonder if his philosophy is that if it goes to three games, Axelsen would prefer to finish the match at his preferred end of the court. Some players like to get off to a good start in a deciding game, should it go to a decider. Other players like the best end to finish at. Oh, this is a blister of a start.
Five.
By Axelsen. Oh,
Love.
Wang Tzu Wei here at the India Open, lost in the first round to Lin Dan.
Service over. 8-1.
Euron is a different class of player, but he's not showing it quite yet in this second game. Even in the first.
Service over. 2-8.
Both players are struggling to control pushes and lifts on both ends of the court. Saw that right at the end of the opening game, didn't we? Looking concerned is Jonasson, former world number two himself in the men's singles, Nick Jonasson.
Play.
That's clever serve, I like that. Seven, to eight.
Ten.
Serving low, but serving out wide. Point advantage to Viktor Axelsen at the mid-game interval here in the second. Well, when you consider he was 7-love up, only having a 4-point advantage at the mid-game interval. Well, 4 points can easily be closed, and all of a sudden it's believable for Wang Tzu Wei again.
Good.
Well, I think most of the fans here.
11-7.
Surrey Fort Sports Complex would love to see a decider here. Yeah, it's found the back line.
12-7.
Shot. Well, I still wonder whether that's hip injury to Wang Tzu Wei is bothering him.
So,
well, he's got back his second point advantage as Axelsen. Short rallies.
9-15.
Going his racket immediately, looked at his racket, and I think it's okay. Oh no, it's not.
16-9.
There he was looking almost as if he was finishing the shot. He was looking at the strings of his racket. Yeah, it's a very, very aware when the string goes. As if we will be treated to a third and deciding game. Tell you. we weren't seeing it at the time, but I can tell you that this man was had his hand on his hip. Obviously that's dive where he landed heavily on his hip. Maybe that's still bothering him. Well, it was a service error that ended the opening for Axelsen. We've got rather more of a cushion though here in the second end. Goodness, that's brilliant. Amazing control from both players at the front of the court.
90.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Because I said right at the start, there was incredible speed and control at the front of the court, Wang Tzu Wei. Really demonstrated it in the last few rallies. Oh, well, it's called out again.
Viktor Axelsen challenges. Out.
And again. I thought that was in. What does Hawkeye say, more importantly? Yeah, clearly in. How on earth was that called out?
Direction in.
No, it's just as well we've got the challenge system.
Service over.
So seven
game point
opportunities. And racing to a 7-love lead at the start of the second game. Now, seems all important, doesn't it? Oh yes, that's nice. Clever. Good disguise.
20.
The court attendant, he'd had a good old mop. You need the moisture actually picked up by the mop rather than just spread about. Short. Yeah, this time he converts. One game all.
Won by Viktor Axelsen. 21-14. One game all.
21-14. Yeah, there you are. That's that 7-point advantage that he had right at the start of this second game, and it's made all the difference. One game all.
जाने के बाद one, 20 seconds. Good one, 20 seconds.
Third and deciding game gets underway. Yeah. And I wonder if that's a sign of things to come. Desperation from Wang Tzu Wei. Smash down his forehand side and then the block to the backhand net, making him twist and turn.
You just guide him.
Just about the first body smash that Axelsen has used, isn't it? I remember his opponent hitting two wonderful
love
body smashes. One at the end of the first game, one at the end of the second game.
It's over. One, two.
Well, he's beaten all of the top big star players as Viktor Axelsen. Victories over Lin Dan, Chen Long, Li Chongwei. In fact, his first ever victory over Li Chongwei came at the Super Series finals in last year. And of course, that's when Axelsen went on to take his first ever Super Series title.
Like.
Oh yes, well taken.
Two, three.
Yeah, doing exactly the same to Axelsen as Axelsen had done to him. Smash out wide. Ah, oh, now Axelsen's gonna do a little bit of housekeeping himself, yeah. That's what we need, a good old mop there. There we go, that's better.
flag.
Wang Tzu Wei needs to be a little bit careful here, because I just feel that it looks to me as if he's running out of ideas. But that was perfect. You have to believe in yourself. Oh, yes. Now, I wonder if he sensed what I sensed.
Five,
a big effort, four, and all of a sudden he's back level. Oh, my goodness, that he made look easy, and I can assure you that wasn't easy. Shuttle was tumbling, six, and for him to control five. That, you just look how the shuttle's upside down, spinning. And yet Axelsen managed to play the perfect response.
Six.
Yeah, she's pleased with that. Well, it's all about the front
seven
of the court, really. I think this men's singles, because both players are very wary of lifting to the back, because the shuttle is flying so fast, it's going most of the time going long. There we are, there, just to prove me wrong.
8-7.
Brilliant. Well, certainly no lack of effort, is there? And clever play from Axelsen, making his opponent twist and turn two back to the same place. And the obvious shot would have been straight down Wang Tzu Wei's forehand side, but no, he plays back to the backhand, but an attacking shot. It's that twist and turning that's so draining physically. 35 shots. Is that the longest of the match?
So, ready? Guide him. Black.
Judgment. He knew immediately that was going to go long at the back line. Didn't panic, Axelsen.
11-8.
Calmly played the defensive shot into the open space. And the number three seed has a 3-point advantage as they change ends in this third and deciding game.
Ready to play.
So what has this young man got left? Wang Tzu Wei.
11-8. Play.
There's only 3 points in it. Expecting a backhand smash from Axelsen there.
Eight.
In fact, he was looking for the drop shot, I suspect. Here's the lift. Look, he was about to go forward looking for a drop shot. That's a magnificent backhand smash, though, from the tall Dane. Says he's unsighted. Well, challenge here because I think it was called out. I have to say, I thought it was out. I'm not quite sure why the line judge was unsighted. No, it was clearly out.
Out. Service over. 9, 12.
He knew that it was unlikely that Axelsen was going to lift from the front of the court because the shuttle is flying so quickly. And once you've got to the net first, you might as well stand your ground. Yeah, look at him.
I should call the referee.
Casual as you like, waiting there.
So, you have banned?
Now, what's Kenneth Jonasson saying? You can't just play it straight back to the net. You've got to turn in. You've got to do something different. Yeah, and I agree.
Like.
Well, we often talk about a drift in these big arenas. No, that's gone wrong. And I can tell you that it's not just the natural air currents here at Sewing Fort.
13.
There's a huge amount of air conditioning on. In fact, I'm right up by the air conditioning. And I've got on 5 layers. Should try and keep warm. Just wide. It's 1 point in it.
12, 13.
Oh yes.
And it's over. 14, 12.
How important the net play would be. Yeah, it really is just waiting for that now, Wang Tzu Wei. To no avail. It's one game all. It's 14 all. I think the strings may have gone in the racket of Wang Tzu Wei.
15, 14. Quick.
Well, point by point. And of course, Chinese Taipei had a first ever finalist at the All-England Championships earlier this month, and a first ever title in the form of Taipei. Tai Su Ying. It is a country that's doing very, very well in badminton terms. Well, as the match 16, clock ticks 30. Over the hour mark, the two-time former finalist has a two-point advantage. Landed in. Oh, there's a challenge. Well, it's the first challenge of the match for Wang Tzu Wei. Well, Axelsen gave it extra height and he played it to perfection.
Unsuccessful. Tzu Wei won. One challenge remaining.
Well, after so many lifts and pushes that have gone long, that time from Axelsen, it was perfect.
Black.
My goodness me, that was brilliantly taken off the top of the tape from Axelsen. Yeah. No wonder he applauds.
14.
Oof. Oh, that's amazing. He won't get any closer than that. Lovely. Finds the line.
15-18.
An indication of how much drift there is. Hardly seemed to touch that backhand. Very nearly landed on the red carpet surround. Yeah, look at this. Hardly touches it. That's miles out. Oh, yes. Well, the problem for Wang Tzu Wei, he dared not clear it for fear of it going out, but
20.
Very
match
difficult
point,
from
16.
That position to play an accurate drop shot. Four match point opportunities for Viktor Axelsen.
Game.
Only needed the one. Safely through to the semi-final once more. A two-time beaten finalist over the last 2 years is still on course to perhaps make it three finals in 3 years.
Match won by Viktor Axelsen.
Had to come from behind though. 19-21, 21-14, 21-16 in the deciding game in a match lasting just over the hour mark, an hour and 4 minutes to be precise. This is the final rally. There was good control on the front of the court there. And then the power play. And coach scuttling off to go and watch his men's doubles players on the adjoining court. But there is confirmation of the score. 19-21, 21-14, 21-16 in the deciding game. That's three of our five quarterfinals have been completed, and that men's singles an excellent encounter, and the only match so far, as you can see, that's gone the full distance. Mixed doubles is up next with Mr. and Mrs. Adcock against Isara and Amaparapai. And then we finish with that much anticipated encounter between the two divas of Indian badminton. Saina Nehwal, the World Championship silver medalist, against the Olympic silver medalist, Pusala Venkata Sindhu. Both players with Olympic medals, both players with World Championship medals. And of course, both players, absolute megastars here in India. Our next match being mixed doubles, a chance for us to look at the mixed doubles draw from the quarterfinal stage. Seven different nations involved and six seeds. The only seeds to lose were the number five seeds, Puravaran, Kro and Tedrak Thanachai, who of course won the Swiss Grand Prix gold. They lost in the first round. And Pranav Jerry Chopra and Siki Reddy, the number seven seeds, lost yesterday to the Russian pair of Dremen and Dimova. So we, though, are going to concentrate on that third quarter of the draw. The Adcocks, the Commonwealth Games gold medalists,